Monday, August 12, 2019. Giamatte elected Guatemala president. Conservative Alejandro Giamatte was elected as Guatemala's president on Sunday, defeating former First Lady Sandra Torres in a runoff. He had polled almost 58.5% with a lead of 550,000 votes and only a few thousand left to count when the court declared him the victor. Giamatte will be under immense pressure from the U.S. to implement a controversial migration pact that would allow Washington to send most Honduran and Salvadorian asylum seekers who passed through Guatemala back to the poor, crime-stricken country.
¡Ganamos, Guatemala!
Hong Kong police and protesters clashed in cat-and-mouse encounters across the city on Sunday, marking a shift in tactics during a 10th straight weekend of unrest. North Korea said leader Kim Jong-un supervised test firings of an unspecified new weapons system. A gunman armed with multiple weapons opened fire in a mosque near Oslo, injuring one person before being overpowered by an elderly worshipper and arrested. Muslims clash with Israeli police at Jerusalem holy site. Muslim worshippers and Israeli police clashed Sunday at a major Jerusalem holy site during prayers marking the Islamic holiday of Eid al-Adha. Palestinian medics said at least 14 people were wounded, one seriously, in the skirmishes with police at the site. The clashes came amid heightened tensions between Israel and the Palestinians, just days after an Israeli soldier was killed south of Jerusalem. The White House is getting a makeover, courtesy of a few hundred gallons of specialty paint designed to preserve the storied building. Authorities across the country were investigating threats against businesses and public events on Saturday, a week after mass shootings in El Paso, Texas, and Dayton, Ohio. Authorities arrested a Las Vegas man who discussed attacking a local synagogue and charged him on Friday in connection with bomb-making materials found in his home. The cause of Jeffrey Epstein's death awaits further information. The New York City Medical Examiner's Office said that it had completed an autopsy of the financier Jeffrey Epstein, but that it needed more information before determining the cause of death. Multiple people briefed on the investigation told NBC News that suicide remains the presumed cause of death, and that no sign of foul play has emerged in the day and a half since Epstein was found unresponsive in his federal jail cell. Unfounded conspiracy theories flourished online in the wake of Epstein's death, none of which have yet to provide sufficient evidence. A Brooklyn resident who allegedly sprayed a Hasidic man with an unknown substance and made anti-Semitic remarks has been arrested and charged with a hate crime. In the wake of the latest mass shootings, a Crown Heights yeshiva for girls is the first school in NYC to install metal security doors armed at protecting kids from active shooters. Governor Andrew Cuomo signed new legislation Friday that prohibits employee discrimination based on religious attire or facial hair.